Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday 8th, SpaceX successfully launched their 40th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1111.
One, ignition, liftoff of the Falcon 9, go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1093, then landed successfully for the first time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 2 in terminal guidance. Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
On Saturday 12th, SpaceX successfully launched their 41st Falcon mission of the year with the launch of NROL 192.
One. Ignition, liftoff of the Falcon 9, go SpaceX, go NROL 192.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 24th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
For Falcon 9 to land on our drone ship Of Course I Still Love You, which is stationed in the Pacific Ocean.
Landing leg deploy.
On Sunday 13th, SpaceX successfully launched their 42nd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1217.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1083, then landed successfully for the 10th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
On Monday 14th, SpaceX successfully launched their 43rd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 673.
1. Ignition. Engines full power and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1067, then became the first booster to land for a 27th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Landing leg deploy.
Stage 2 in terminal guidance.
On Sunday 20th, SpaceX successfully launched their 44th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of NROL 145.
And liftoff of the Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go NROL 145.
The booster which launched this mission, B1082, then landed successfully for the 12th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stationed in the Pacific.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
On Monday 21st, SpaceX successfully launched their 45th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of CRS-32. The booster which launched this mission, B1092, then landed successfully for the third time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 1.
Precision landing.
Deploy.
On Tuesday 22nd, SpaceX successfully launched their 46th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Bandwagon 3.
And liftoff. Go Falcon, go Bandwagon 3.
Stage 1 propulsion is nominal.
The booster which launched this mission, B1090, then landed successfully for the third time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 2. Then, Friday 25th, SpaceX successfully launched their 47th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 674.
1. Ignition. And liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the 23rd time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors. Tonight and going into the week, we can hopefully expect to see a bunch of Starlink missions. The first of these, the Starlink 119 mission, is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 27th at 11:41 PM UTC or 7:31 PM EDT. Tomorrow we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1223 mission is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 28th at 3:58 a.m. UTC, or today, Sunday 27th at 11:58 p.m. EDT. The following day, we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1210 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 29th at 2:37 a.m. UTC, or Monday 28th at 10:37 p.m. EDT. A couple of days later and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 675 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday, May 1st at 3:17 a.m. UTC, or Wednesday, April 30th at 11:17 p.m. EDT. Later the same day and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 153 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday, May 1st at 7:40 p.m. UTC, or 3:40 p.m. EDT. SpaceX has once again been selected by Intuitive Machines to launch their fourth lunar lander mission. Heading to Boca Chica, work is continuing on the Pad B flame trench. The flame diverter bucket was recently lifted down into the flame trench. The second bucket was also seen being installed. The orbital Pad B's orbital launch mount legs were recently installed. Work is also continuing on the Pad B orbital launch mount itself. Work has been continuing on demolishing the high bay. Also being demolished is the Stargate building. Here's a look at the work continuing with the housing construction. Work on the roundabout construction is continuing as well. There was a picture posted on Reddit showing a flame trench similar to the one being built for Pad B at Starbase being built at LC-39A in Florida. There was also a picture posted of the launch mount for the LC-39A Starship launch pad. There was a Reddit post with some rumors related to Starship. It says Booster 14-2 will only use two engines for landing to test engine out scenario. Flight 11 will reuse Booster 15 which flew on Flight 8. There were pictures posted with information about a vacuum optimized Raptor 3 engine spotted at SpaceX's McGregor testing facility. This Test Tank 17 test article was spotted in the production yard. Starship 37 has been seen being stacked inside Mega Bay 2. This Ship 39 LOX header tank was seen inside Star Factory. After the static fire test, Booster 14 was rolled back. Booster 17 was recently seen undergoing some cryogenic testing. After testing recently, Booster 17 was moved over to the Rocket Garden. As always, I have to say thanks to Cesar Garcia, Jack Beyer and Gage Telesz for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.